Could you help us understand the difference between the term vegan and whole food plant-based?
Oh my, such an important distinction. Thank you for that question. Vegan. I've been vegan now for 38 years, and it's the most important life-affirming, life-saving, beautiful ahimsa concept that I can be aware of, and I'm a passionate promoter of all things vegan. And of course, it's a life causing as little conscious harm as possible, and having the consumer goods in your life, whether it's the food you eat, the clothes you wear, the items that you buy, be free of animal products, no meat, fish, dairy, or eggs in the food choices, and no leather and fur and wool and all the other products that are taken from animals that inevitably involve their suffering. A life free of that is a vegan life. And if I could push a button and make everybody vegan on this planet and have that consciousness in everybody's head instantly, I think you could disband the United Nations tomorrow and the earth would heal and everyone would have enough to eat. All sorts of wonderful things would happen. So I'm a big fan of people going to a vegan diet and lifestyle. That said, welcome to the 21st century, and the vegan food manufacturers have created a whole wonderful panoply of taste treats that are recapitulating all the goodies that we like, you know, that are made with meat and dairy and eggs, etc., all the cakes and cookies and baked goods and candies and drinks and processed foods, the snacks, the chips and the schnips and the bips and all of those. They're now vegan. And it's true that there's no non-human animal suffering involved in the creation of these products, but there's one animal that eventually does suffer from ingestion of too many of these products, of course, and it is us. These products flood the body with refined sugars and oils and free radicals and molecules that are really injurious to the body. And you wind up with vegan people, God bless them, overweight, diabetic, with all the same maladies as our omnivorous brethren and sistren get. And much to my dismay, I've got a couple of overweight vegans who can't keep their hands off those vegan bakers. Their baker is, one fellow's a baker himself, and he's 230 pounds. He's got gout, and now he's officially had his first heart attack, and he has angina. They did a scan, and his arteries are as grotty as any of my meat-eating patients. And so this is serious business. You can really hurt yourself on a vegan diet if it's filled with all these refined products that flood the body with these sugars and oils and reactive proteins. So just because it's vegan, you know, it's light years beyond non-vegan as far as ethics and harmony with the natural world. But as far as true health, those of us concerned about this, both the scientific clinicians, the dietitians, the doctors, etc., but just the aware public. In the last 10 years, I've been so gratified to see this migration away from pure vegan to the more refined but scientifically precise term whole food plant-based. And there's so much in that term that it's worth looking at in some detail. We've sometimes smeared all together, oh, whole food plant-based diets, you know. But, you know, whole food, that's really so important. This is making the majority of your meals, the majority of food that goes down your gullet, that brings calories and protein, starches, the macronutrients. They are in their whole plant form, like you could recognize them growing in the garden. Oh, there's a potato, there's carrots, there's cucumbers, there's peas, there's squash. Those are whole plant foods, and that includes field grains, wheat and rye, barley, oats, millet, buckwheat, farro. There's so many wonderful grains these days. This should constitute the majority of food that we ingest. And if you do that, it guarantees you getting these magic ingredients, the soluble fiber, the insoluble fiber that keeps your digestive system working, that fosters beneficial bacteria in your colon. It'll give you the beneficial omega-3 fats. It'll give you the proteins and carbohydrates in a very slowly digestible, natural form. It's the basic diet that we humans were designed to eat. We are plant-eating hominids. You know, we don't have claws on our hands. We have fingers. You know, we have the short intestines of a house cat. We got the long intestines like gorillas and bonobos. And we have essentially the same digestive system as our plant-eating hominid ape-like relatives have. And they're up in the trees eating leaves and fruit. And that's basically the pattern that we should be following. Now, it doesn't mean that you can't take advantage from time to time of some of these processed treat foods and a teaspoon of maple syrup in your tea. And yes, it's a processed food, but to add a little flavoring, a little seasoning, that's fine. And even the occasional veggie burger, some of these new meat-like vegetable burgers that are out now, that once a month as a treat, you know, it really doesn't cause any great harm. And if it gives you great pleasure and brings back wonderful memories, okay. But on a daily fare, when it comes to your breakfast, lunch, dinner, the vast majority of what you chew up and swallow should be whole plant food. And if you do that, you wind up a lean, healthy vegan with open arteries and normal blood pressures and normal blood sugars and free of most of those maladies that get you involved with people like me. And as much as I love all of you, I'd like to see you on the bike path and the health food store. That's about it. I don't want you spending much time in doctor's offices and being a medical patient. Yeah. The whole food plant-based diet, yes, it is vegan, is the key to that. So all healthy diets, as far as I'm concerned, are whole food plant-based. They're all vegan, but not all vegan foods are healthy. They're not all whole food plant-based. So you get the idea. Think about the your eating day. A breakfast of oatmeal and fruit, lunches and dinners full of salads and hearty vegetable soups and steamed veggies and bean burritos and hearty clean no oil stir fries. There's so many wonderful dishes in whole food plant-based cuisine. Explore all the international flavors, Italian, East Indian, Mexican, Asian, and you'll have plenty to satisfy your taste buds and your tummy with a whole food plant-based diet. So hopefully we get the difference between vegan and whole food plant-based. Yay!
Absolutely. And I know that there's the term a vegan who eats junk food, like vegan junk food, you know, and it's like what you're talking about, those processed foods, but you can't, there's no junk food when it comes to whole food plant-based.
Yes, absolutely. You know, if you really want to be healthy, it's important to set a good example. And if you're skimming along on energy drinks and granola bars and everything you're eating is out of a shiny package and it's devitalized and there's nothing alive in your daily diet, it shows in your skin and your bodily functions, etc. Again, be true to our nature as whole plant food eaters. You'll find, I think it's a very important point that you made there. Thank you. Hi, everyone. Dr. Michael Clapper here, announcing our new format for our Q&A with Dr. K. Each day, Annie Hagen will be asking me one question that's been sent in by our viewers. So if you want to see if your question is getting answered, do join us for our daily Q&A with Dr. K right here. Hope to see you then.